Upon release of the 2023 UCE results today, we visited several schools in Kasese Municipality, where we found learners filled with joy and excitement for passing the UCE exams despite several ADF attacks they experienced in the year 2023. The most disastrous attack was on 16th June 2023 on Mpondwe Rubiriha Secondary School in Mpondwe Town Council. This attack saw over 40 learners lose their lives, most learners getting traumatized. However, due to security enhancement, including UPDF guarding schools to assure learners and people of Kasese of security during the exams, learners have been able to excel.
We have 84 learners who registered sit for these exams, and out of 84 learners who registered, 18 have been able to get Division 1. With the best having 12 aggregates in 8, followed by the one of 17 in 8, 19 in 8, and many others were in Division 1 according to the number of first grade students. Then in Division 2, we have got 33 learners, and in Division 3, we have got 24. Division 4, we have got 8 learners, and none of the learners failed to get the certificate.
We were in touch with the police, which beefed security in the school to keep the situation calm. Because of that, we were able to go through up to the examination without any interference.
According to Judith Abusinje, the deputy head teacher of Kasese Secondary School, that took up the 11 students who survived the Mpondwe Rubiriha SSADF attack, revealed that as a school, they embarked on endless counseling of the learners in order to prepare them for the 2023 UNEB exams.
The remainers, those who remained from the school where there was an attack, we took them on, the 11 students, the only survivors, we brought them here. Because we have a good facility for counseling and guidance, and we brought them. So they have promoted to senior 3, those who are in senior 2. And because of that, we were able to go through up to the examination without any interference.
Various school authorities commended security operatives, including Uganda People's Defense Force, Uganda Police Force and other agencies for the support rendered to the learning institutions, especially safeguarding the learners.
And our learners were very positive from the statements that would come from the security personnel, and out of that, they remained calm and did not affect their performance. I'm very grateful for RDC of this district and all other security personnel, the police officers who managed to come here and talk to these learners so that they can get comforted. And out of that, we have really seen this great.
Learners expressed a tremendous joy for excelling in the exams despite the ADF impact. Relatedly, parents, students and teachers at Kagadi Government Aided Secondary School in Kagadi District are celebrating success upon getting multitudes of first grades.
Today I'm glad that we have got many first grades. Those are our 32. And we shall make sure this year for us in senior 4 we get more than those ones.
According to the head teacher of the school, Ramadan Barongo, they have scored 32 first grades and over 100 second grades, registering achievements in the 2023 UCE exams. He attributed success to commitment of teachers, students and parents.
We received our UCE results of 2023 today. And our students in Division 1, we have got 32 Division 1s, and the best got 14. There were two students who got the best, the boy and the girl. And their results have generally been good. The factors that have helped to have good performance, we have committed and had working staff who work as a team during day and night, and they are able to supervise the big numbers of our students. Another factor is we have parents who are cooperative, providing requirements of their learner, of their children in time.
The best candidates thanked parents and teachers for nurturing them morally and academically, promising to also excel at higher levels.
So I'm also thanking my parents who have enabled me to achieve this goal, perform highly in my O level. Then I'm taking also this opportunity to advise my fellow students who are still doing the same in their ordinary level. They should work hard and take education as the first priority.
Story compiled by Samuel Amanyire and Andrew Msingzi for the news.